Well, let's now give you the updated numbers and the larger picture on the stranded Indians who have been brought back home to India through special flights. The latest in this process of repatriation exercise called Vande Bharat Mission, 800 people have returned from abroad. 446 Indians returned from Manila and San Francisco to Mumbai. 446 of them landed in Mumbai. 326 Indians from London have arrived in Bengaluru. On arrival, the passengers have all had to go through, firstly, a thermal scanner at the airport. Air India Express has been also regularly operating repatriation exercises and flights since the 7th of May. So the latest, of course, being 800 returning this morning back to India. Indians who were stranded in the United Kingdom have landed in Bengaluru this morning. So passengers were allowed to move only in the batches of 20, and around 16 BMTC buses were arranged to ferry them to specific hotels across Bengaluru where they will have to be in quarantine. This is compulsory quarantine for people who have landed from abroad, and all these facilities have been arranged in certain specific locations, mostly in hotels. 16 BMTC buses carried these people from the airport to these hotels in Bengaluru. Out of the 326 passengers, two passengers had medical emergencies. The rest of the asymptomatic passengers have been quarantined for a period of 14 days. Shrija joining me with the latest information. Shrija, what is the status of the passengers landing from UK to Bengaluru? Where have they been taken? What are the arrangements made for them?
Well, Afrida, this is in fact the first flight, very first repatriation flight arranged by the UK government to in fact allow the passengers, the Indian passengers, to travel all the way here and land in Bengaluru. Now, as far as this particular flight is concerned, it landed here at Kempe Gowda International Airport. This is around 4:47 a.m. And remember, we're talking about the kind of standard operating procedure. This is as per the MHA was clearly followed. Soon after they had landed, even while collecting the baggages, we understand they were only sent in 20 numbers. This is in different batches, and after which we understand thermal screening was conducted on each of these people. Remember, there were over 323 people, a total of 326. This is including one particular body which is flown all the way from the UK till Bengaluru, where a man had committed suicide. Now, that particular the list of the passengers also includes this. Now, as far as the SOPs are concerned, we see thermal screening was conducted, but so far we understand from the authorities, the nodal officers, what they tell us is that none of the passengers have shown any sort of symptoms, exhibited any sort of symptoms as far as COVID-19 is concerned, which is why we understand that all of them have right now been sent for 14-day, in fact, quarantine. Now, remember, the next 2 to 3 days is going to be very crucial, because just about yesterday, we saw a very huge spike as far as Karnataka is concerned, and this was just a single day. It's a record what we are looking at. So that particular, in fact, the segment that we are talking about is especially people, the migrants who had arrived from other states to Karnataka. So they were tested positive. So the next couple of days going to be very crucial for the state of Karnataka. For now, what we understand is that as per the authorities, they say that none of the passengers have exhibited the COVID-19 symptoms. And we see two of the 326 passengers, they had a medical emergency. One of them was a cancer patient, and both of patients have been right now they have been taken to the respective hospitals. And apart from that, we see that these 323 people, they were transported in especially 16 different BMTC, the Bengaluru Transportation Corporation buses. This is to the respective places, be it whether it is a quarantine center, institutional quarantine center, whether by the government, arranged by the government, or even for that matter, remember, it was left at the discretion of the people over there, whether they wanted to stay in a hotel or in a resort. So these are the different things that have been taken care by the Karnataka government, considering the fact that this is the first flight that has landed here in the state. In the next 2 days, we are going to see two more flights, which is coming in from the US, as well as the third flight, which is landing here in Bengaluru, Kempe Gowda International Airport, on May 13th. This is from Singapore. Back to you.
Right. So going further, Srija, as one can understand that even though their destinations, all of their destinations may not be Bengaluru, they might be hoping to move to other places, they will have to now compulsorily stay in Bengaluru for a period of 2 weeks. Srija?
Right, Frida, considering the fact, that's right, absolutely, because remember, they will have to follow this particular protocol laid down not just by the MHA but also Karnataka government, because remember, they clearly stating that 14 day is the quarantine period. Once that is done, remember, even the tests, their samples have already been collected, so the next 2 to 3 days we will have to wait and watch. Remember, the government will keep a close watch on them, whether they are turning, in fact they are being tested positive for COVID-19 or not. So the next 40 days is going to be very crucial for the Karnataka government. Right. Of course, they cannot travel to their respective districts where exactly they are from, not just from Bengaluru. Like you did point out, there are several of the passengers in these 326 who are not only from Bengaluru but across Karnataka as well. But for now, they will have to continue to stay here in Bengaluru.
Right, so huge respite for these passengers who have landed back home, but then again, they will have to now go through a rigorous process of 14 days of quarantine, and further testing might be required if they show any symptoms at all. So all that is going to be strictly monitored by the authorities. Srija, thanks for joining us with your latest inputs on this.